Sejam muito bem-vindos ao Museu Bienal de Cerveira. O meu nome é Fernando Nogueira e sou presidente da Fundação Bienal de Arte de Cerveira. É com muita honra que participamos nesta edição digital da Conferência de Best in Heritage, que todos os anos dá a conhecer as melhores práticas desenvolvidas a nível mundial da área da museologia, património e da conservação. Distinguido pela Associação Portuguesa de Museologia em 2019 como o melhor museu português do ano, o Museu Bienal de Cerveira abriu portas em 2002, mas resulta de um projeto iniciado em 1978, ano da criação da Bienal Internacional de Arte de Cerveira. Há 42 anos, o artista Jaime Isidoro foi desafiado pelo então Presidente da Câmara Municipal, João Lemos Costa, a trazer a arte contemporânea ao encontro do espaço rural e dos cerveirenses. É assim que se decide pela organização da 5ª edição dos Encontros Internacionais de Arte, dando origem à primeira Bienal Internacional de Arte de Cerveira. Reconhecido por ser um dos eventos mais marcantes das artes plásticas e uma referência da cultura artística nacional e internacional, afirma-se hoje como a Bienal de Arte mais antiga de Portugal e da Península Ibérica em atividade. Cada edição apresenta, em média, mais de 600 obras feitas por 400 artistas de mais de 30 países. Com muito esforço, resiliência, o evento permanece até aos dias de hoje, em grande parte graças aos seus sócios fundadores e verdadeiros impulsionadores, Jaime Isidoro, José Rodrigues e Henrique Silva. Gerido desde 2011 pela Fundação Bienal de Arte de Cerveira, o museu não pode ser dissociado de todo este enquadramento histórico. É mais, é claramente uma consequência deste fenómeno cultural que tornou Vila Nova de Cerveira conhecida e reconhecida internacionalmente como a Vila das Artes. O Museu Bienal de Cerveira visa, assim, a promoção da arte contemporânea através da organização de iniciativas artísticas e culturais. Possui um importante acervo representativo da evolução da arte moderna e contemporânea portuguesa e internacional das últimas 4 décadas. No total, é composto por mais de 700 obras de arte de prémios adquiridos ao longo das 21 edições das bienais e doações de artistas. Através da sua atividade museológica, contribui para a descentralização da oferta cultural e estabelece-se como um espaço de encontro e interação de artistas, bem como de formação e desenvolvimento de públicos através do serviço educativo. Ao longo do ano, são promovidas exposições de artistas emergentes, consagrados, bem como itinerâncias do acervo dentro e fora do país. Assumindo um compromisso artístico com o património desde 1978, também se procura proporcionar experiências fora de portas ao nosso público. Vila Nova de Cerveira é um museu ao céu aberto, onde se mantém uma simbiose perfeita entre o património cultural, paisagístico e o desenvolvimento do território. Por isso, hoje, marcamos presença graças a todo este trabalho em prol da cultura e das artes que se tem vindo a desenvolver ao longo destes 42 anos. Acreditamos que o prémio do Melhor Museu 2019 reforça e sublinha não só a excelência do nosso trabalho, mas também o facto de sermos um importante caso de estudo em Portugal, de como o investimento em projetos culturais pode resultar no desenvolvimento social, cultural e económico de um território.
This interview will present one of the laureates, and this time it's Cerveira Biennial Museum. And with me here in this interview is Miss Ana Vale Costa from the Communications Department of the museum. You are very welcome, Ana.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here.
As the Best in Heritage is about awarded projects, I want to first congratulate you for having been awarded as the Museum of the Year 2019 in Portugal. And would you like to then describe briefly your museum? Thank you.
Sure, thank you. So the Cerveira Biennial Museum is located in the north of Portugal, in Vila Nova de Cerveira, which is internationally known as the Village of Arts. So we are a small town border Spain with moreover 9,000 residents. The Cerveira Biennial Museum aims the promotion of contemporary art and cultural heritage by promoting artistic and cultural events. It holds an important collection representative of the evolution of Portuguese and international modern and contemporary art from the last four decades. It has moreover 700 artworks, modern and contemporary art. Some are artworks acquired and some are artist donations. So all throughout the year, we promote exhibitions from emerging to already known artists, as well as tours from our collection nationally and abroad, and some educational activities.
So I would be curious to know what were the particular qualities or innovation that impressed the prize jury?
So we believe that the Best Museum Award was assigned to our project because it really underlines not only the excellence of the work that has been developed during these 42 years, but also the fact that we are an important Portuguese case study of how investment on cultural projects can bring positive impacts in what touristic, economic, and social development concerns for the territories. So through all these years, we have been encouraging the production of avant-garde art in relationship with our cultural heritage and the public space. That's why we have an indoor and outdoor museum. So you, when you came to Vila Nova de Cerveira, you can also have an open-air museum.
The village where you are located is quite small. So yeah. I'm sure there is sometimes some challenges also in arranging. You have been rising to a big, very national-wide festival, very well-known. So have you faced any challenges in developing your museum and your festival?
Yeah, indeed. So in 42 years, the difficulties were several. But I would say the biggest concern and challenge were and still definitely is the lack of funding, I think, that reaches the whole cultural sector. But we also have positive experiences, such as to looking back these 42 years, and since the beginning, there has been so much done with so few resources. That is something that we should point also. So we have this well-known Portuguese poet. I don't know if our audience knows him, Fernando Pessoa, that he used to say, "Man dreams, the work is born." And I think this project is precisely the result of the utopia and resilience of its creators, of the decision makers, politics, artists, and community all together. So I think the result and this continuity of this project, it's really a beautiful example how art can develop a small town such as Vila Nova de Cerveira.
Definitely, I agree 100% with you. Very beautiful example of such an initiative. So you have a lot of visitors in the biennial festivals and in your museum also. So can you tell a little bit more about the visitors, maybe the visitor numbers, but also where do they come from and what is your relationship with the museum, your visitors?
Okay, so per year, the numbers usually fluctuate because we have from 2 and 2 years our huge biennial of art. So the number raises and that years, but the average is around 100,000 visitors in the Cerveira Biennial Museum per year. So people came mostly from Portugal, but also from abroad, especially from Galicia, that is on the border. It's in the north of Spain. And the Spanish people usually come to Vila Nova de Cerveira because we have a bridge that separates the two towns, and our relations are really good. So we are they are really coming to and interested in cultural activities. But if we talk in terms of our educational service and activities, we may say receiving our museum more than 5,000 participants per year. We are talking about kids and visitors that participate in guided tours, workshops to school, creative holidays for kids, and so on. So the scope of participants on our activities goes from the region school segment to also the senior public of, for example, daycare centers. So we work with these targets all year.
I think it's very interesting when you talk about the effect of this artistic collaboration, bringing the artist into the village. Can you tell a little bit more about what kind of change this activity and those artists and this collaboration, what kind of change has it brought to the city? Has it changed the how the city life is?
For example, I said, during these 42 years, people, artists leave artworks on the open air. They have projects abroad. So they have a really footprint on our village. We have really, really, I'm not quite sure how many, but we have so many artworks on our village. That's why we are called the Village of Arts in Portugal and known for it. And for example, I think it's an interesting example to talk about. We have a small village in Vila Nova de Cerveira that is known also for the Village of Artists, because people during all these years stayed and make their roots on Vila Nova de Cerveira, and some changed their residence to be here because you really breathe art here. You feel like it's a good place to work and develop your production, artistic production, and to talk with poets, talk with the visual artists, talk with the actors, and they stay here. They love to stay here because it's really a good environment to be.
Oh, wonderful! It really feels like it's a place to visit when you visit Portugal as a tourist. You have to come.
Yes, I recommend.
As it sounds so intriguing. So one last question. So what would you see as the main subject for future development in your museum?
So looking to the future, we aim to extend our internationalization so we can pursue our mission of promoting contemporary art through an artistic and universal language. And in an intercultural dialogue, I think it's very important to bring all the artists from all over the world here and see what they can do in relationship with the territory. For example, this year, in spite of the circumstances we all know, we are keeping up with the new technologies. So we are going to create a virtual visit to our exhibitions, so everyone in the world can visit us. I think it's a good thing, and it's a good step for our internationalization also. And also, I will say for the development of the Cerveira Biennial Museum, I think another goal is to maintain this connection between artists, public, and the village, increasing our important role as a culture mediator, and contributing to the raising awareness of the future audiences, because I think the future audiences need to be worked really hard. That's why we are working with kids from the school since they are very little, because they will grown up and they are the future of our country.
This is a beautiful way of conclude this interview. Thank you so much, Anna. It was really...
You're welcome. It was a pleasure. Thank you.
Very, very interesting. And I would just conclude that this is a beautiful example of a museum that was born out of an artistic citizen festival. firstly, and then it has become really a success story, an example of sustainability in an artistic and cultural life of the village, also reflecting and having the impact on not only local and regional, but also on national and international level. And you have brought the life of the art as part of the life of the city and the lives of the citizens, and hence kind of created accessibility to artistic encounters and a very rich exchange of artistic ideas and innovation. So I really warmly congratulate you for your beautiful project, and I wish you the best of luck for the and also in this conference of Best in Heritage. And I hope we will see you soon again.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
Thank you.